Welcome to our channel. In this session, we are going to discuss about setter and getter methods. What is the purpose of this one? For example, we have some data. Data in the sense variable. How to load data by using constructor, we can assign the data. By using methods, we can initialize the data. And by using object reference variable also, we can assign the data. Finally, by using setter and getter methods also, we can load the data. We can use any procedure. Generally, assume if I have roll number, name, age, some gender, three variables are there. So, I created one constructor, general procedure. By using this constructor, I initialize all the four variables. And one method, assume one method is their display. Within the display method, I display all the variables. General procedure. But right now, my intention is one separate method for each variable. You need to assign a separate method for each variable. That is, to initialize roll number, I created one method. To initialize name, one method. To initialize age, one method. To initialize gender, one method. Similarly, instead of using one method for displaying all the values, I use a separate method. Why? For example, right now I required age. But if I call display, all the four values are printed. But you need only age. So for that, we are using setter and getter methods. So setter method is used for initialize the variable. Getter method is used for retrieve the value. So how to create set variable name of some parameter. So retrieving means some return type, get to variable name of. Okay, we are setting this variable with this parameter. We are getting the variable with return type. For example, I will explain with one example program. Suppose consider some customer details. Assume the customer consists of ID of the customer. You can think anything. Name of the customer, city, PIN code, and phone number. These are the five variables. Now, how to write a method name? First, I will explain set method like this. Set ID of, set name of, N capital letter, set city of, set PIN code of, set phone number of. Like this, for each variable, you are writing five methods. Similarly, for retrieving, get ID, get name, get city, get PIN code, get phone number. Like this, you need to create setters and getter methods. Observe, here you have five variables. It is difficult to write 10 methods. Now, generally, IDEs provide the predefined setter and getter methods. How? I will show you. The first two step is open Eclipse IDE. Procedure, file, new project. Here, select Java project. So project name is demo setter and getter. This is my project name. Spaces are not allowed. Suppose demo setter. Assume this is my project name. Click on no. Now here, go to this one. Source, under this source, new package. create one package. Assume the package name is some pack one. You can create any name within this pack one. Create one class name class. Customer details. This is my class. Finish. Okay. One package with one class is created. So within this class, what I am doing? Public. Whatever you want. String ID. Name. And remaining city. Suppose if you want, you can write pin code. All these are string format. If you want, you can write integer also, public or long, phone number. Okay, fine. So just now I declared the variables. Right now you need to write 10 methods. 5 setter methods for initialization, 5 getter methods for retrieval. Instead of writing, simply right click. Here, see, we have multiple options are there. Go to the option source. Right click at the empty space. Go to the option source. Here, observe, generate, getters and setters. Simply click on this one. For 5 variables you want? Yes, simply select all. For all the 5 variables, what are the access modifier you required? You can select any one. Generate. See this one? Automatically, set ID, get ID, set name, get name, all the methods. So, get means it return. Set means it assign the value. Clear? So, very simple procedure. Like this, you can create setters and getters method. Now, create under the source new package, create another package, assume pack 2. Within this package, new class, my class name is suppose customer main. This class consists of main method. This class consists of main method. Now import pack 1 dot star, import java dot util dot star. Now here you need to write the logic. What you need to write? Simply read all the data. So scanner sc is equal to new scanner of system dot in. Anyway, I think everyone understand how, what is the syntax of setter and getter. Again, I will show you. See this one. If your variable name is ID, the setter method is set ID of, getter method is get ID, variable name is name, get name, set name. Set means we are passing parameter without return type. Get means we are no parameter with return type. Now, clear? Now, read all the values. System.out.println. What are the required? Enter ID. Semicolon. Enter ID. Now, initialize directly. Set ID. Enter ID. You need to create an object. Yes or no? Customer details. OB is equal to new customer details of, yes or no? By creating object only, we are calling the methods ob.setId of sc. Next line of. You are reading the string. Now observe, enter the ID directly. Instead of assigning the variable, directly I assigned. Now, like this, read all the information. Enter ID, enter name, enter what are the other things, whatever. Name, ID, city, pin code. Name is okay, city, pin code, phone number. Now read one by one. OB dot set name. SC dot next line of. Fine. Now OB dot set city. SC dot next line of. Automatically you got the advantage. Automatically the methods are displayed. OB dot set phone name pin code. Simply select and then click SC dot next line of. OB dot set phone number. SC dot next long of. OB dot next long, sorry, next long of. We are reading all the details. We are reading all the details. After that, if you want to print, my program is just reading and printing. System dot out dot print ln. Details are. Now print the details. How? Inside the statement, system dot out dot print ln. Within this, why return some value? So OB dot get ID. Now OB dot get name. OB dot get city. OB dot get pin code. OB dot get phone number. Now all the details are saved. Save. Go to customer details. Here also save the program. Now you observe how to write the setter methods. For each variable you are writing one method, and for each variable for retrieving also we are writing one method. Run. Enter ID. S1 2. This is my ID. Enter name. Enter city. Enter pin code. Whatever it is. Enter phone number. So these are my details. These are my details. You got it? This is the way to use setter and getter methods. And one more thing. And most of the members, suppose if the font size is very low. If the font size is low. Not only this setter getter methods, for this Eclipse IDE, if you want to increase the font size, go to window, select the options, preferences, click on preferences, here general, under general, appearance, under appearance, colors and fonts, click on this one. Now here colors and fonts, you have Java. Colors and fonts, you have Java editor text to font. Yes or no? Click on this one. Click on this one. See, here you can select your own whatever the format. Suppose, see this one, I changed the size to 22. Click on OK. Apply, apply and close. See this one, the font size changed or not. So like this, you can expand the font size or you can decrease the font size. This is the way to use Eclipse and setters getters method. Thank you.